Hi, I'm Varsha Suresh. The paper I'm going to introduce is about how to use only attention mechanism for machine translation. Earlier approaches usually used encoder-decoder based architectures to perform this. For example, to translate "she loves to read books" to its French counterpart, the input is encoded into a fixed length vector which is passed to the decoder for translation. The deficiency for this approach is that no matter the sequence length, the encoded vector is assumed to contain all the relevant information required for translation. This makes it difficult to handle long-range dependencies. Attention solves this by concentrating on the most related parts during translation. For example, here, in order to translate the word "she," it focuses on the first part of the vector as compared to the others. This approach made neural machine translation much faster and accurate, and is commonly referred to as the transformer architecture.
Hi, my name is Reyha Verma, and I will present the paper "Attention is All You Need." So I will start by giving a little background as to why we need this attention mechanism. There already were some very famous sequence-to-sequence models like RNNs and CNNs available for machine translation when this attention mechanism was proposed. But these models had some limitations, like they were hard to parallelize and efficiency dropped for longer sequences. Also, if it were parallelizable, the model took a lot of time for computation. Hence, attention helped eliminate recurrence altogether. So let's go forward and define what attention is. Attention basically means that each time the model predicts an output word, it only uses parts of an input where the most relevant information is concentrated instead of an entire sentence. That is, it pays attention to only some input words and not all of it. There are basically three types of self-attention mechanisms used in this framework. The first one is the encoder-decoder attention, where every word from decoder looks at all the relevant words from the encoder. The second one is the encoder self-attention, where every word in the encoder looks at every other word in the input to compute the attention score or to find the most relevant part. The third one is the mass self-attention, where every word in the decoder looks only at all the preceding words and masks the word succeeding it. So this is the model known as the transformer, which is proposed here. It is similar to the encoder-decoder network. The left side of the architecture forms the encoder and the right part forms the decoder. These are the major components of the transformer architecture. The multi-head attention and the positional encoding forms the most important components of the all. There are two types of attention mechanisms used in this architecture. The first one is the scale dot product, which is calculating the attention score using the dot product, which is much faster and space efficient. It is computed as shown in the formula given here. Dk is the scaling factor that prevents softmax function getting pushed into regions where it has very small gradients. And the second one is the multi-head attention, which allows the model to jointly attend to information from different representation subspaces at different positions. Here, H is equal to 8, which means 8 heads are used. Also, since there is no recurrence or convolution in this model, positional encodings are used to maintain the order of the sequence. It forms a very important component of the transformer architecture. Now, coming to experiments, two models were trained here, the big model and the base model as per the specifications listed here. The blue scores were used as the evaluation metric. So, as we can see, on English to German translation, the big model achieves a blue score of 28.4, which is the new state of the art. Also, on English to French task, the big model achieves a blue score of 41.8, which is the highest. The training cost of the base model is also reduced to almost 1/4 of the previous state-of-the-art models, which shows the competency of this transformer architecture. Therefore, Transformer is the first model based entirely on attention, which has replaced the recurrent and convolution layers and trains faster than the earlier architectures. For more information, please go ahead and read the paper. Here are the links to the paper, code, and the related blogs. Thanks for listening.